My name is Roger Davis. This story took place in 2013. It was the beginning of summer, and me and my brother Wes had just gotten to my Uncle Matt's house in Marysville, which is a couple of miles from the nearby Mississippi River. Uncle Matt gave us his famous Matt hugs as we entered. After we unpacked, we had a few drinks, since Wes had finally turned 21 last month, since I'm only a year older. But he had drunk before on several occasions. We just chatted about nonsensical stuff, played pool, all the fun stuff. The next day, we left to go camping since our Aunt Melissa was away on a business trip. As we were driving, my uncle told us that there may be gators or bull sharks in the Mississippi River. But then he told us that he had seen something much worse down there when he was about our age. He spoke of a 7 or 8 feet tall lake monster that resembled a more monstrous version of the creature from the Black Lagoon. "You've got to be pulling our chain," Wes said. "No, my boy, it's all true. I saw the thing when I was fishing for a walleye. When I was reeling in my catch, it actually had the balls to try and take my fish. I thought that it was a bull shark at first, until I reeled in the head of the walleye and I saw them glowing eyes under the water. I almost shit myself when I got a better look at it." My brother still didn't really believe it, but he gave Uncle Matt the benefit of the doubt. But I was quite intrigued. My uncle was 6'4 and lifted weights every day. The guy is practically built like Vin Diesel. He is usually never scared of remotely anything. So if this thing managed to do it, then it must have been a big deal. When we parked at the camping spot, we walked the trail down to the small beach connected to the river. We unpacked our camping gear, fishing gear, and Uncle Matt's AR-15 rifle, which he kept in a special case. After setting up our tents, me and Wes went into the woods to get firewood. When dusk set in, we were cooking the 2 walleyes we had caught. As Wes was cooking the potatoes, I heard the water splash near the shallow part of the beach. "What was that?" I said. "Probably a catfish," Wes said. The splashing then happens again before it stops once more. "Hope that ain't a gator," Uncle Matt said. "No way, not out here," Wes said. We were listening to the song Asylum by Disturbed while we were eating. When we finished, I shot my girlfriend some pictures of the walleyes that we caught before stuffing the phone into my pocket. Wes goes to take a piss out in the bushes.
"Hope there ain't no snake in them bushes," Uncle Matt said, sipping a beer.
"Ha ha, funny," Wes says. I then decided to take a dip in the river since it was as hot as hell that day. After taking off my white tank top, I changed into my bathing suit before jumping in. My Uncle Matt was reading a hardcover copy of the book It, while Wes was playing a game on his phone. When I went underwater for the second time, I felt something like a hand tightly grab my left calf. I opened my eyes in the blurry water to barely make out some sort of humanoid thing with sharp spikes on its back. I kicked it as hard as I could several times until it finally relented when I gave it a good kick to what I assume was its face. I darted out of the water, screaming like a banshee towards Uncle Matt and Wes. I noticed 3 big, but not severe or fatal cuts on my calf.
"What happened?"
Uncle Matt asked. "There's something in the water," I said, as he grabs the first aid kit out of his tent.
"What are you talking about?"
Wes said. "I saw it. It wasn't a bull shark. It was something else. Something ugly," I said. Uncle Matt comes out with the gauze and peroxide.
He cleans and dresses my wound before wrapping my calf in gauze.
Did you get a good look at it?
Uncle Matt said. Sorta. It was the size of a man, probably bigger. And it had these spikes on its back, I said.
Shit, it has to be the monster from the story, Wes said.
Oh, now you believe it, I said.
Well, what the hell fish leaves a precise scratch like that? Wes said.
My uncle then stands frozen, looking at the river. I and Wes go to see what's wrong. Then we both freeze in fear as well when we see the two glowing eyes of a yellowish-green color from underwater. They were completely devoid of any irises or pupils. Just practically Call of Duty zombie-style eyes.
What is that?
Wes said. Uncle Matt runs to retrieve his rifle. He fires 4 rounds into the water to scare it off. When the waves in the water from the bullets settle, the eyes are gone.
Looks like it left, for now, Uncle Matt said.
What if it comes back? I said.
We've got weapons, so if it comes back, we can hopefully just light it up,
Uncle Matt said.
If it can't go on land, I guess we'll be good, Wes said.
When we clocked out for the night, I kept watch for the monster with the AR-15, since it was the only gun we had on us besides the .357. After 20 minutes pass, I got bored, and I decided to pass the time by playing Angry Birds. When I went to wake up Uncle Matt for his watch shift, I heard a loud, alligator-like hissing noise coming from the bushes where Wes had pissed. However, the small growl that followed the hissing was nothing that an alligator would sound off. I slowly and cautiously walked up to the bush, gun tightly grasped in my hand. I turned on its underbarrel flashlight and used the night vision scope that was attached to see what was in there. I aimed the flashlight at the bush, and what I saw would make even seasoned veterans shit themselves. It was a large, grayish, humanoid creature with fin-like webs on its forearms. It also had webbing on its 3-toed feet. It had a tail resembling that of a catfish, black spikes on its back, 3-fingered hands with sharp claws, and a maw filled with pointed teeth, as well as yellow eyes with black slanted pupils like that of a snake. It hisses at me as it opens its mouth. I yelled and fired nearly the entire magazine at it while screaming my lungs out from fear. I must have hit it because it shrieked in pain as it darted past me on all fours, back into the water. I ran back to the tents to see Wes and Uncle Matt up with machetes in hand, lowering them with relief when they saw me.
Are you okay, Roger? Uncle Matt said.
Yeah. I managed to get a good shot at it, and it retreated, I said. Let's just get our asses back to the house right now,
Wes said as we run to the car with nothing but our weapons. We sped the hell out of there as soon as we got into the car. Uncle Matt called the police about what had happened, while me and Wes had a couple of more beers to process what had happened. The next morning, we went to retrieve our stuff. Several police cruisers were already there. Our tents and everything else were untouched, but all of our food was predictably gone, and our coolers were completely trashed.
Better that being eaten than us, Wes said.
Yeah, no shit, I said.
We talked to the sheriff for a little bit about what we had seen. He said that he wouldn't have believed us, if not for the blue blood that they recovered.
Blood?
Uncle Matt asked. Yep, whatever you shot definitely wasn't no gator or anything around here. In my 38 years on the force, I've never done a case like this, said the sheriff as we get our tents and fishing gear. They seized our destroyed coolers for evidence, which we obviously didn't mind. After the incident, we haven't talked about the river creature, as my uncle called it since. It's 2019, and we still haven't seen or heard of it to this day. I'm now 28 years old and married to my beautiful wife of 5 years. But my only fear is that if there are a whole species of those things lurking in the river somewhere, well, my advice is if you go camping by the Mississippi River, please have some protection on you. I'll update you guys if anything else happens.